highly, highly disconcerting. As elected officials, I don't need to remind everyone on this committee that our loyalty is to country first, to Canada first. Before party, before individuals, we are here to act in the best interest of the country. And you, Madam Chair, like me, swore an oath. We swore to serve and defend the country and the values for which it stands. And the military defends those values, but we must also embody them. And I would like to remind you, Madam Chair, of the words on our commissioning scroll that places the trust and confidence in us, in our loyalty, our courage, and our integrity. And you, Madam Chair, never unswore that oath. Canadians are counting on you. Men and women in uniform are counting on you to lead by example and put your service to this country and to this committee and this parliament before yourself.
I think that as honorable members, we do not attack the integrity of other honorable members. And I think that Ms. Alice Love is getting very, very close to that in her remarks. And I would ask her to please treat all members with respect and dignity and integrity. Thank you.
Thank you. Carry on, Madame Alice Love.
Well, thank you very much. But I would remind that this chair, as a commissioned officer and an elected member of parliament, we must all put our country above our own personal gain or position. And that is not what has happened. What we have seen, Madam Chair, from the actions last Friday is that a motion was brought to entertain another witness, and you ruled it out of order. When in fact, there was no question that it was not out of order because the motion simply said what we were going to study and the recommendations would be by Friday and that the report for the study would be by a future date. It did not in any way say that no new witnesses could be brought forward. And this is not a new witness. This is someone that we have been trying to get at committee since the 8th of March. So then we challenged your decision and we were able to overrule your decision. And then, Madam Chair, in return, you suspended the committee meeting for 80 minutes as a punishment for bringing this motion forward without giving 48 hours notice, when in fact it is protocol and generally accepted that we bring motions, but nothing, absolutely nothing, prevents us from bringing motions to the floor. And so your rule, Madam Chair, as I understand it, is to facilitate the process fairly and honorably, not to punish members of Parliament on the committee. Then you failed to monitor the debate to ensure that there was relevance around the topic that we were discussing, as well as that points were not being made repeatedly over and over again. If the motion on the table is to bring a specific witness, Elder Marquez, forward, then the debate should be around that, not about whether or not we have enough recommendations that we don't need to review this anymore, because of course we don't know what testimony a witness is going to bring until we actually hear from that witness. So it is unconscionable that we would debate that because we have so much other information which may or may not be relevant to what this witness is going to say, we don't need to hear anymore. But we are counting on you, Madam Chair, to ensure the will of the committee, not just a few Liberal members, Madam Chair, but the will of the committee is maintained. And it was clear on Friday that the will of the committee was not to adjourn. And Madam Chair, you did not have the will of the committee to adjourn. It was clearly the will of the committee to get to a vote on this critical motion before adjourning. And again, This motion is not some frivolous procedural motion. This is a critically important motion. This committee is essentially the last line of defense in all the things that we're doing to get to the bottom of sexual misconduct, abuse of authority, harassment, discrimination in one of the most important institutions of our country, the Canadian Armed Forces. We have heard of the repeated failures in the process, and we still do not have answers as to how a chief of the defense staff could not only remain in his position for 3 years with unresolved allegations of sexual misconduct, but no security review was conducted, and he received his performance at risk pay and a salary increase and was allowed to become the longest serving chief of the defense staff ever. This motion is to hear from an individual who is in the Prime Minister's office. Ministerial accountability only comes if we know who knew what when. We can't just take the Minister of National Defense's word for it. And the Minister of National Defense clearly said he didn't. He told his chief of staff, who he believes told Elder Marquez. Who Elder Marquez told, we don't know. And yet, that's very important because we heard from the clerk of the Privy Council that a plan was put forward to the Prime Minister to remove the CDS, change the CDS before the last election. But for whatever reason, that didn't happen. And like I said, he received his performance at risk pay and a salary increase and was extended for the longest serving CDS ever. How could that have occurred while there were unresolved sexual allegations of sexual misconduct against the highest officer in the land? We have not done our job. We are the last line of defense until we know exactly what Elder Marquez in the Prime Minister's office knew, who he told, and how this occurred. Because it is our job to fix the processes, yes, and we've heard lots of recommendations around processes. But this is not only about processes, this is about the individuals in critical positions and whether or not they followed those processes. Because when people fail to do what they've been entrusted to do, then we need to understand how we can fix a system or how we can hold those people accountable so that it doesn't happen again. So for the government to say we don't need to hear more testimony is unconscionable. And again, the committee decides, and the will of the committee is to hear from this critical witness. And no change will occur if those who have the authority and responsibility do nothing or allow the process to be frustrated and critical information not provided. And you, Madam Chair, from your actions on Friday, are complicit in preventing this committee from doing the will of the committee. So we implore you, Madam Chair, to use the powers vested in you with loyalty to country, integrity, and the courage to do what is right, not what is easy, and to put the best interests of the country, the rule of law, our democracy, and the sacred responsibility to our fellow men and women in the Canadian Armed Forces, to honor them and fight for their desire to be treated fairly and serve free from harassment and discrimination. And Madam Chair, we can only do that, our job as a committee, as the last line of defense, if we hear this critical testimony from Elder Marquez, and if you, Madam Chair, facilitate fairly, procedurally, openly, honestly, the will of the committee and the best interests of the country first.